And you mentioned Steve Gleason. Let's get into that for a second. Steve Gleason, somebody had ALS, obviously, and as his life went on and he moved on from football, what's been really crazy is and cool is to see the way that block punt and that moment, because it was really the block punt lifted everything. That was the exhale, let's say it that way. I think for everybody where he came in and said, hey, this is going to be special. And then you see sort of the way what that meant to the community. Well, then you see how the community and the world has continued to back Steve Gleason through everything he's gone through. It was incredible to see the platform start and how the platform continued, even for him, somebody that may not be as much of a household name as, you know, Drew Brees for much of this, but really had this signifying moment for the community.
Yeah, well, and he's really always like he's still such a figure around there. Like when I was there for those couple off seasons, Steve was a presence around the locker room, and you would see him going in and out there. And what he does in that community and what he does at large, certainly for ALS, but just in general as someone who's so philanthropic, the way that he's been, it's unbelievably inspiring. And that moment is now immortalized forever, that block punt out in front of the stadium there. And I remember hearing him talk about it, I think in an interview online, basically saying, you know, this isn't about me blocking the punt or one moment. It is about New Orleans sharing that moment together. That statue is for a team and a time and a place and this group of people that all came together in that one, him really being the vessel for it. But someone who took that moment, and like you said, maybe as a player was never going to be remembered the way that Drew was for the totality of his career. But one moment that he has turned into a lifetime of service is one of the most inspirational things you'll ever see.
Well, and he even acknowledged in a ESPN.com article a couple of days ago that he's never gone back and watched the game. So he's never actually watched that back in its entirety. So this for him is going to be a special. And he mentioned being nervous, I think was a quote about it, nervous to rewatch this game and this moment. But, you know, to your point, there's a statue for it outside, and no more fitting statue and no more fitting to this story that it's not a statue of Drew Brees and it's not a statue of Sean Payton. It's a statue of Steve Gleason blocking a punt against their biggest rival in the moment that the entire team and city and nation came back together for New Orleans.
You know what's funny about this one is this is such a well-known moment for that portion of it. Do you know who scored the touchdown?
No, I don't.
His name's Curtis Deloach. I think he only spent one season with New Orleans, but I was reading an article on NOLA.com the other day, and the funny part about it is Curtis played on defense, so he was on the field for the third down prior to forcing the punt. And so he was off on the sideline standing next to the special teams coordinator at the time. And the special teams coordinator noticed they only had 10 players out on the field. So he motioned for Curtis to run out there and get out there. And so Curtis goes running onto the field. He's the last guy on the field for that punt block. And he looks over and he goes, one of the other guys I got out there, he told me where to line up and said, just go rush the punt and try and block it. And sure enough, he goes through there, is right after Steve Gleason, and picks up the ball and ends up scoring the touchdown on that play.
That is incredible, Mike. That is absolutely, I mean, it just shows you sort of the fate. And, I'm not a big fan of the concept or fate of destiny in football games or in sports in general, where you feel like it was just, you know, there was some will to win. Like, I'm not a big fan of that premise. But when you watch that game, that's what it felt like. It just felt like larger than life. Like, it was just intended for the Saints to win this. And even up to, you know, me being the music geek that I am, like the concert beforehand, which was U2 and Green Day were the ones that were playing beforehand. And like everything felt special about it. It never felt like a Monday night football game. It felt more like a Super Bowl in that sense. And the way we were all watching it felt like a Super Bowl in that sense. And then when you have this fate, this play that feels like fate, it just felt like, again, like exhale is maybe not the right word, but it felt like the world celebrated, the country celebrated that moment together for everybody. And for a minute, at least, we weren't thinking of it, because the lasting effects of Katrina, I mean, they're still being felt in New Orleans. But for that moment, you could just forget about all of it.
One of the other cool things in going back, and NOLA.com did a really good article talking to all the different people. So the Monday night booth at that point was Mike Tirico, Joe Theismann, and Tony Kornheiser. And Tirico was talking about the sort of organic way that thing came about. And he said two interesting things. He said, one, I got really lucky, because with a punt block and a special teams play, it's really difficult to be able to know who all the numbers are, because like you said, sometimes you have guys that are running onto the field late that maybe weren't supposed to be out there. But he said, he goes, just by sheer luck and our spotter, I was able to get the numbers right away. And then as soon as he crossed the end zone and scored, Tirico said, he goes, I made a very conscious note to say touchdown New Orleans and not touchdown Saints. He goes, because that moment belonged to the city and all those people. And then he's like, I gave the international symbol for layout to Kornheiser and Theismann, kind of reminding everybody that nothing we're going to say is better than what this crowd is going to provide in this moment. And he was absolutely right. Like that double thud that you hear on every special teams play gone wrong into that moment. Like I got chills just talking about it right now. I'm sure I'll cry tonight watching the thing. Like they did such a good job, and it's not to pat our fellow media members on the back, even though Tirico is one of the best, if not the best in the biz, like to let that moment just breathe, because on its own, it's so much more than we could have ever made it.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.